Meeting your boyfriend's kids is stressful enough, but imagine meeting them after you've been caught carrying on a decades-long affair with their dad. Keep watching to find out how Camilla Parker Bowles' first face-to-face with Prince William really went. Throughout Prince Charles' marriage to Princess Diana, the first in the line of succession to the British throne maintained a friendship with his former girlfriend, Camilla Parker Bowles. Charles and Camilla also had a secret affair that was anything but secret.
Mrs. Parker Bowles is a great friend of mine. I have a large number of friends I'm terribly lucky to have.
In 1994, the prince admitted to it in the ITV documentary Charles, The Private Man, The Public Role. When asked if he had been faithful to Diana, Charles said yes, but then he paused and added the bombshell, until it became irretrievably broken down, us both having tried.
As I've said before, it is a deeply regrettable thing to happen.
By that point, he and Diana were already separated, but the royal family continued to oppose the divorce. That changed, though, when Diana conceded the infamous November 1995 interview to Martin Bashir, in which she said Charles' affair with Camilla contributed to their separation. A month later, Queen Elizabeth urged the couple to formally divorce, according to the New York Times. Charles and Diana's divorce proceedings were finalized in August 1996. If the world knew about the Diana-Charles-Camilla love triangle, Prince William and Prince Harry also knew. But even though Camilla had been in Charles' life for decades, William and Harry had never met her. That didn't happen until a year after Diana's tragic passing. And as you could probably guess, the meeting was tense. The decision to meet Camilla came from Prince William himself. According to Cheat Sheet, Prince Charles had planned to go public with his relationship with Camilla after he and Princess Diana divorced in 1996. But before Charles could do that, Diana passed away in a tragic accident that stunned the world. So he decided to keep it on the low. Prince Harry and William showed no interest in meeting their father's partner, considering everything that went down, and Charles respected it, according to the report. A year after his mother's death, though, William thought it was time. On June 12, 1998, just days before his 16th birthday, William dropped in unexpectedly at St. James Palace, where he knew Camilla would be visiting with his father to rip that band-aid off, as the Irish Times reported in July 1998. In the 2017 biography, The Duchess, The Untold Story, royal biographer Penny Jr. explained that Charles introduced William and Camilla and then left them alone. They chatted for about a half hour, minutes that apparently had a strong impact on Camilla. As Jr. detailed in the biography, Camilla came out saying, "I need a gin and tonic." We know the meeting took place because Charles' aides confirmed it to the press, but whether Camilla really said she needed some help to alleviate her anxiety is still uncertain, though it will certainly remain a thread in the fabric of the popular country. Perhaps there was yet another instance that left Camilla pining for a stiff drink. Princess Diana's highly publicized 1995 interview with BBC One's Martin Bashir. As you may recall, Diana spilled all of the royal tea during the candid interview, in which she discussed her issues with bulimia, her rumored affair, and yes, Camilla. When asked whether or not she believed Camilla played an integral role in the demise of her marriage to Prince Charles, the late princess famously said,
"Well, there were three of us in this marriage, so it was a bit crowded."
It's reported that Camilla watched the bombshell interview play out on television along with the rest of the world, and it appears she had some strong feelings about it. Rather than getting angry about the tell-all, royal biographer Penny Jr. told Vanity Fair that Camilla found the entire spectacle comical and was amazed by the, quote, sheer theatricality of it all. Amused or not, however, Camilla never publicly addressed it. According to journalist Mary Braid, Camilla's silence and discretion regarding the jaw-dropping interview was simply how she operated. Braid went on to say, "This is a woman who has endured without a whisper an avalanche of public insults after Prince Charles told millions about their affair on television. This is a woman who once encountered a journalist breaking into her downstairs loo, and who had the contents of a family album, taken without her consent, splashed all over a newspaper. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one."